We greet you in the matchless name of Jesus the Christ, our Lord and Savior. We want to welcome you this evening to Taking the Word to the World. I am Pastor Jerald J., along with First Lady, the Reverend Luella H. Thomas, of the Elm Grove Baptist Church in Meridian, Georgia, where our motto is, Everybody is somebody in the Lord. We're emanating from our station here in the beautiful town of Hilliard, Florida this evening, and we'll pray that someone would be saved. Someone's life will be totally changed. We want to welcome you, our Elm Grove Baptist Church family. We ask that you come in, have a seat. Amen. Get your sword out and let's get ready to rumble. Also, want to thank all of our Facebook and YouTube viewers for your love, your support financially, spiritually, for your prayers. We just thank God for you. And we pray that this word will be a blessing to you, you, and you. We ask that you like, share, comment, and on our YouTube, why don't you subscribe? Ask someone else to subscribe. It'll help us to continue to keep a treasure trove of the Word of God at your disposal so that when we are not live, you can go right to YouTube and pick up an in-season word that will be a blessing to you and to your situation. So now, if you would, let us go before God's rich throne of grace. Amen. Father God, it is in the matchless name of Jesus. We humbly come now. Father, we come before thy throne with thanksgiving, and we come with praise. So, Father, now we ask as we totally surrender, speak through us through the power of the Holy Ghost, and let us be able to rightly divide this word and proclaim it that a life would be changed, a soul would be saved, conditions would be bettered. And Lord, I just thank you right now for what you're doing. There's a miraculous healing that's going to take place. Several will take place in this atmosphere and in this environment because it is a holy environment. And God, we thank you, but eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, neither has it entered into our heart what you have prepared for us. So we invite you, Holy Ghost. Come on and break it through. Touch, save, and deliver. In Jesus' matchless name we pray. And everybody said, amen, amen, and amen. Come on, let's celebrate the Lord on this beautiful summer's eve. God has been, still is, and shall continually be good to all of us. In our times of studying and looking through the treasure trove of the Word of God, God placed in our spirit and upon our hearts tonight to talk about you as a believer and me as a believer, believing in and upon the Word of God. So I want to talk to you tonight from the subject of believing God for our healing.
Amen.
And you might ask the question, Pastor, what kind of healing? Well, man is a threefold being, body, soul, and spirit. And a lot of times on this Christian journey, when our emotions are distraught, we only seek emotional help. We want to solve the problem. Or if we are having a physical dilemma, we want to get healed from that physical disability. And even spiritually, sometimes we are hurt spiritually through the church and through other acts that transpire. And a lot of times we only focus on our hurt. But as Jesus the Christ spoke to the man in the Gospel of St. John, the 5th chapter, somewhere around the 19th verse, he asked him, he said, do you want to be made whole? A part of us getting healed is not the answer. The total man from head to toe, God has the power to heal, to deliver, and to set free. But the thing about it is, we must have, as a believer, enough faith to believe that God will.
Yes.
Now, the enemy will always talk you out of your blessing.
Mm-hmm.
He will tell you, you are unworthy.
That's right.
I was unworthy
mm-hmm.
until I accepted the unadulterated Word of God.
Amen.
And I found out in the Word of God that God gave His only begotten Son.
Amen.
And His Son gave His life
mm-hmm.
so that you and I
mm-hmm.
could have everlasting life.
Yes.
One thing we must know unequivocally is that God has paid our sin
Amen.
Debt.
And
Amen. Upon us receiving
yes.
the redemptive work that Jesus Christ wrought out on Calvary. Amen. We can and we will
yes.
be saved.
Amen.
We will be healed.
Yes.
We will be delivered.
Yes.
But my brother and sister, faith without works is dead.
Yes.
You must believe that God is
yes.
and that God can
Boy,
and
yes.
that God will.
Amen.
Come on and
yes.
give the Lord a great big hand of praise.
Glory.
And just look
Glory.
To the hills
mm-hmm.
from whence cometh your help. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Knowing all the time
yes.
that your help cometh from the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Oh yes, man will set you up.
Yes.
Man will fail
Glory.
You.
Yes.
But the
yes.
Lord God promised
yes.
us that I will never
Glory.
Leave you.
Yes,
nor
yes,
forsake
Lord.
You. He
yes.
said, Lo, I'll
yes,
be with
yes,
you
yes,
even
yes.
until the very end.
Yes,
the end
yes,
of what, Pastor?
Right.
Until the end of this world. Amen. And I'm coming back, Jesus
yes,
said.
Yes,
I'm coming back to
yes,
get my church,
yes,
my blood bought, my
yes,
believer,
yes,
my redeemed.
Hallelujah.
I'm coming back to get
yes,
you. Come
God.
On and help me in here now.
Hallelujah.
And God said, Look at here. I will not never leave
yes.
you comforted.
Thank
he
Lord.
Said
yes.
in the word, Amen.
Uh-huh.
Amen, that many of us, brothers and sisters, who proclaim to be saved,
mm-hmm.
we are sick
mm.
and we are suffering.
Yes.
Just because you are saved does not alleviate the attacks
mm-hmm.
that Satan
That's
will
right.
bring upon you.
That's right.
Because Satan is the accuser
mm-hmm.
of the brethren.
Amen.
Satan is always looking
mm-hmm.
to kill,
mm-hmm.
to steal,
mm-hmm.
and to destroy.
Yes.
And you got to recognize him
mm-hmm.
and his handiwork
mm-hmm.
because he is one that will divide, and he know that a house divided
mm-hmm.
cannot stand
Amen.
And will not stand.
Right.
Satan's
right.
job
yes.
is to disrupt
uh-huh.
and to destroy
yes.
and to take
yes.
you out of the miracle
yes.
super work plan
yes.
that God has
oh,
for us.
Yes.
Don't you know, my brother and sister,
yes.
that God is a supernatural
yes.
God.
Yes.
That God
yes.
can do anything
yes.
but fail.
Yes.
We have to learn
yes.
to place our trust
yes.
in the Lord.
Yes.
Now look what the old eagle-eyed
uh-huh.
prophet Isaiah stated.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. In Isaiah 53:1, if you have your sword
mm-hmm.
with you,
mm-hmm.
I want you to know one thing. If God said it, you can go to the bank on
Amen.
It. It Amen. Will and it shall
yes.
be done.
Yes.
Oh, yes, he mm-hmm. said in Isaiah, the 53rd chapter,
mm-hmm.
and verse number 5,
uh-huh.
he said, but he, talking about, now Isaiah is prophesying
mm-hmm.
700 years
yes.
before
mm-hmm.
Jesus Christ came upon the face of the earth.
Mm-hmm.
That's just how the word of God fits so perfectly
mm-hmm.
in a line for all of us to know one thing for sure, that if God be for you,
oh, yes.
he's more than anyone
yes.
or anything
you,
against you.
Yes.
It says, but he was wounded for what? For our transgressions. I don't care how saved you are.
Mm-hmm.
You had already been saved.
All, right.
All your life you hadn't been saved.
Uh-huh.
There have been some ups and downs,
oh,
some
yes.
trials,
yes,
some tribulations.
Lord.
Amen. Some things we all done wrong.
Oh, yes.
But I come
Thank
to tell you
God.
On this evening, we serve a God
yes.
that says, cast all your cares
yes.
upon him.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because he cares for you.
Yes.
Don't you know that our God is a jealous God?
Yes.
Anytime you love anything or
Lord.
Anyone or
yes.
any something
uh-huh.
more than you do God,
God
is a jealous God.
God. Yes.
He knows
yes.
how to shake it up
oh, yes.
because God wants yes. your undivided
yes.
attention.
Yes.
My
Thank
brothers
you.
And sisters, uh-huh. many of us fall by the wayside
yes.
because we miss God.
My
we
God.
Take our He said, and the chastisement
yes.
of our peace was upon him.
Yes.
Amen. Uh-huh. And with his stripes, take your name off. Every stripe that Jesus took. Uh-huh. If you can believe that Jesus was beaten on Calvary, and you know it in your heart.
Yes.
It's just a time. This is what we live and believe.
Yes.
If you believe it,
yes,
and you can trust in it. So 39 stripes are indicative of the healing. He took the healing just for you.
Yes.
He's telling you here. He said the chastisement of our peace was upon him.
Yes.
And with his stripes, right. Come on somebody,
come on,
confess it tonight. Confess it in the atmosphere,
yes,
in the virtual atmosphere.
Yes.
I dare you to move your mouth, because when you speak, amen, you speak life into yourself. Tell your neighbor, I'm healed,
I'm
delivered, and I'm set free. Why and how? By the power of God Almighty. Only God can heal me. Only God can deliver. Oh, yes, the doctors do a mighty work. But without God, y'all ain't talking to me in there. Come on, virtual. Y'all put your comments in there. Put your amens and your hallelujah. Because we feel a preach coming on in here. Come on now. Now, the Lord says in his word, amen, to enjoy healing from God. We got to first believe in his redemptive work. Now, any believer that does not expect God to do anything for them will most definitely not receive anything. Help me, Jesus. Amen. Just because he said it, amen, you got to have enough faith. Amen. Faith the size of a mustard seed.
Yes.
If you got mustard seed side faith, you start believing God and saying, Lord, I'm confessing.
Yes.
I'm confessing to you. Amen. What I need from you.
Yes.
I'm talking to you, Lord. And I'm not just coming to you to get something from
all
you.
Right.
Amen. I know that you are able.
Yes.
And whatever God has given you, amen, take it back from the enemy. Don't allow the enemy to steal your joy. Steal your peace, to steal your happiness, to steal anything from you. Amen. The Bible declares that no weapon, that is formed against the what? Shall prosper. And everybody that even talk about it, they got an enemy in the judgment. They're going to have to stand and pay the account for it. Amen. So he's saying here, amen, if you can believe in the redemptive word, that he was hung out and hung up for our hang-up.
Yes, thank
if you can believe that, and believe that God wants to give to you.
Yes.
Amen. I know people tell us, oh, you're a sinner. You don't deserve that. Look how you live it. Look what you did last night.
God.
Well, if the truth were told, I don't care how holy you are.
That's
it's
right.
Something you done today.
Amen.
Either by commission or omission, that you have sinned.
Yes,
am I right about it?
Yes.
Amen. So don't wallow in the mire. Know this, that God is a giver.
Yes.
And God gives the perfect gift.
Every
good and perfect gift comes
from
the Lord.
Yes.
That's the why you dwelling on the Lord. So because the Lord is first and foremost.
Yes.
And this is what I found since the COVID pandemic to be missing is the Spirit of God in our presence, in our home, in our churches.
Yes.
We
trying
to put God in there when all you got to do is invite him.
Yes,
all you got to do is invite him, and
Lord.
God will come in and sup with
Hallelujah.
You. He'll feed you
manna
from on high. He'll
Jesus.
Bless you in your down city and in your uprising.
Yes,
know that God wants to bless you.
Yes.
God didn't create you or allow you to come into
Lord.
This earth for you to be hell hacked, beat up from the floor, tore up, lied on, disrespected, kicked to the curb. God didn't call you to come for that.
Jesus.
He said, I came that you might have life and have what? Have life
more
abundantly. God is the giver of abundant life. God wants you to be the head. He called you and told you, you're the head and not the tail. You are above and not beneath. Oh, y'all don't hear me here. You are blessed in the city. You are blessed in the field. You are blessed in your pocketbook blessed. Your mind blessed. Your home blessed. Speak it. I dare you. with your tongue, the creative power to speak into existence.
Thank you, Lord.
The blessing that you're standing in need of. Come on and talk for it. God is a giver. In the gospel according to St. John 3:16, he unequivocally states, and this is the key to the gospel here. But God so loved the world, talking about you now, and me, that he gave, God is a giver, that he gave his only begotten Son. Did you not see God? God know. Now you know God knows what's going to happen to him. The average mother, if you slap their child, they're going to come to their rescue. They're going to be in a fence. But Jesus, knowing that his only begotten Son, who was seated at his right hand and came down from glory to earth to pay the redemptive price for us, God knew what he would encounter, how he would be beaten, spat upon, and lied upon, and handled all kind of ways. And Jesus could have just said, I know I'm done with it. But he knew the mission that he was on. And he knew what he was doing also would save mankind from a wretched hell. But many of us yet and still choose to go to hell and live in hell because we kick God to the side. But I come to tell you every morning that God allows you to be awaken or nighttime, whatever your schedule might be. You need to change your mind. Help me, Holy Ghost. But God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever, just look in the mirror at yourself right now and say, I'm that whosoever. I've been a liar. I've been a cheat. I've been a hustler and a scoundrel. I've been a pimp and a macadamia. I've been a whore out in the streets. I've been some all kind of stuff. But one thing, since I believe, give your neighbor a high five, since I believe, you can talk about me much as you please, but I know I've been bought with a price. I know I'm whole in glory. I got a home in glory, waiting on me. I got a home in glory. I know this whole place is not my home. It's not my permanent dwelling. They said, now if you believe in him, shall not perish, but you, my brother, and my sister, shall have eternally life, eternal life with God.
Have you
ever thought about heaven? I heard a song say, I'm going to walk around heaven all day long. But let me tell you, the sun keeps shining in heaven. Y'all don't hear me. You ain't got to worry about the nighttime. And all that kind of stuff. God got it set up for you. Where you going to enjoy the beauty of life. But you can't rush God. Hunt your neighbor and say you can't hurry God. Some things got to be fulfilled until God comes. I rebuke that suicidal demon right now. You can't, come on here, you can't steal life like that. I rebuke you and I apply the blood of the crucified Savior. You don't have no right, just like you come at bodies with cancer. I rebuke you in the name of Jesus, you cancer demon. To everyone that's in the viewing audience now, I apply the blood of the crucified Savior, in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. Yes, sir, come on here. Come on here. Get your faith lifted. Get your faith lifted. Get ready to step out of the mess into the message. Get ready to step into the glorious happening of the Lord God Jesus Christ. Look what he says here. When you have eternal life, my brother and sister. You got to know now. Tell your neighbor, I'm putting it in my mind. He is a rewarder. God is a rewarder. Amen. As he stated in Hebrews 11:6, he's a rewarder. Order of them that diligently, sister Lee, I mean press. I mean diligent. Yes. Don't love me on Sunday and forget about me on Monday through Saturday. This is a diligent walk here. This is an everyday walk. God ain't looking for no part-time lovers. God is looking for full-time servants. People who want to love on him every day. You don't love God when you need something. Love God when you're loaded. Help me, Holy Ghost. Give the Lord a great big hand of praise here. know that you are. God is asking you right now, what you're liking. What are you liking? Because in God's kingdom, there is no light. No light. If you can call on a God and you have faith enough to believe that he will answer, he told you, I will give you the desires of your heart. When you enjoy doing for me what you're doing, he said, I'll even give you the desires of your heart. I'm going to bless you automatically. But I can take it a little step further. When you enjoy serving me, amen, them things that you've been desiring, I can bless you with it as long as it lines up with my word. Come on here. I'm not going to bless you outside of my word. I'm going to bless you within my word because I have enough blessings. I stand with 10,000 blessings, unlimited blessings in my hand to satisfy the poor. Who is the poor? The poor in spirit, the brokenhearted, the doubtful, the hurt, the lonely, the bereaved. No, y'all ain't talking to me in here. The angry and the downtrodden. We are all with broken hearts. But I come to tell you, God can mend your broken heart right now. If you just ask him, God, fill my heart. Fill my heart with your love. Fill my heart with your love. It ain't in the four chamber heart. It's in my mind. It's in the recesses of my mind. God, I want you to renew my mind. Take me out of the gutter of life and place my feet on the solid rock of life again so I can take a...
Yes, thank you, Lord.
I can take a stand for
you.
Tell your neighbor, whatever you like it.
Whatever you like it.
God got it.
God got it.
Trust him. Believe in him. And watch God deliver. See, God know when you're faking till you make it. God want a sincere. And when you get sincere with God, oh, the blessings are untold. Look what James 1 and 5 and 6 say. Now, if any man, and he's showing us something here. If you want to come with me, let's look at it. If any man like wisdom, let him ask of God. If you like understanding and wisdom, James chapter number 1, verses 5 and 6. If any man, and we're talking about women too, like wisdom, let him ask of God. Because God is the one that giveth to all men. God is a giver. God don't take God will take nothing from you. Don't you know, I heard people say, all them preachers want is your money. And they're not going to bring it to the church. Surely. But the preacher, you are not giving it to the preacher. You are placing it in God's hand. Now the preacher or whosoever's in charge is responsible for how it is handled. But when you give, you are giving to God, not to the one that's receiving it out there, not for the one that asked you for it, but you are giving in obedience. You're giving to God. And I want to tell you today, you cannot beat God's giving. No matter how or what you try to do, God is the best at what he does. Oh, he's a liberal giver. He said that he give it to all men liberally. And when he give, he don't do like man do, go behind your back and talk about you. He don't criticize you. And upbraided not. In other words, that word means to be critical, to criticize folk, to hesitate. When God bless you, he ain't gonna bring up your past, what you used to do. God blessing you because he's God. He ain't blessing you for what you didn't do or what you should have done. God is blessing you for what you asked him for. Come on now, talk to me out there now. Look what he states here. Amen. And God upbraideth, or he don't be criticizing you, and it shall be given to him. God blesses us. You know that? You know why God blesses us a lot of times? To keep us out of trouble. God blesses you, and a lot of us use God's blessing and stay in trouble. God said, come out. Come out. Sixth verse says, but let him what? Ask in faith. When you ask in God, be sincere. Talk to him. He said, when you ask in faith, what did that mean? ask with expectation.
Yes.
Don't you know a little child, when they come to their mama or their papa or their granny, amen, when they come asking, they come with expectation. If they got good grannies and good grandpas and mamas and daddies, they know they're not going to be let down.
Amen.
Now, how much more about a child of God when you come to your Father, Abba, the creator of the heavens and the earth? God don't want to withhold no good thing from you. He said it in his word.
Yes,
amen. When you ask and you ask in faith and you ask in expectation,
God
will do it for
right
you.
Now.
Come on, let's
God.
Read a little bit more here.
He said, but
let him ask in faith, not wavering, being hesitant.
Mm-hmm.
You know how people just, they ask, but they wishy-washy with it. They don't believe. They say why they can't have stuff. Why God can't do it. It's a negative spirit. But you got to rule that negative spirit out of your life. You know, when you're trying to accomplish things, my brothers and sisters, in your family, in your career, on your job, with your team, whatever you got going that includes other people, you don't need negative folk creating a negative environment around you.
Amen.
You need people speaking positively. You need people speaking into you that's going to help you to grow. That's going to make your marriage better. That's going to make your career better. That's going to make your ministry better. You don't need people hanging around you that's always got the negative part. Help me, Holy Ghost. Anybody can be negative, but you got to learn to put people around you, amen, who are not wavering. Come on and give God a great big hand of praise. It says, wavering, for he that wavereth is like a wave of the sea. You know how the wave is. Amen. Driven with the wind and is tossed to and fro. And a lot of us right now are walking in God. We're believing God for a healing, but we're being tossed. Tossed like the wave, to and fro.
Yeah.
And sometimes you just get tired of being tossed. Am I right about it? Tell your neighbor, take a stand here. Take a stand. You're not sinking in quicksand. Take a stand and trust God.
Yes.
As I prepare to close now, I'm getting close to it. It says, for our healing, God will give it to you. God will give it to you. Amen. Let me tell you, I found out, if God don't heal me physically, it ain't because he can't. He's working some things out of me. Tell your neighbor, God is just working some things out of you to make you better than you were before. He promised you he wasn't going to leave you. He promised you he would. Come on, Elton Grove, I hear you out there. Let's punch it up a little bit. I come to tell you today, even if you are in a third world country, God has not forgotten you. God is with you. And one thing that I've learned, I can take a little bit and make it with. So much more when I got abundance, I'm appreciative. Because God can bring you up out of the gut and the mouth. God can place your feet again on a rock to stand. Come on, help me in here. God is a rich giver. How many of y'all know that? God is a rich giver. And don't put your base your life on money all the time. A lot of us base our lives on material blessings. And God is saying it's deeper. It's deeper. Those are just sideline blessings. Because all the wealth that you have, the home, the car, the material things, when Jesus comes, let's go. When you die, that ain't going nowhere with you. Help me, Holy Ghost. So let's look at what God is giving us. He's giving us joy, unspeakable joy. He's giving us peace in the midst of storms. He's giving us long suffering. He's teaching us how to temper ourselves. God knows that we have his love in our heart. God is trying to teach us even how to love our fellow man. Look what he states in 1 Timothy 6 and 17. Command those who are rich by man's standard. And some think they so rich they can't be touched. Mm-hmm. Am I right about it? Mm-hmm. Command those mm-hmm. who are rich mm-hmm. in the world that they not be conceited. Mm-hmm. You know, we get a few dollars, we can get downright nasty. Mm-hmm. You hear me?
Yes.
Don't put your trust in material ownings and blessings.
Uh-huh.
Because sooner or later, if yes. you don't handle it right,
uh-huh.
it's going to be gone.
Yes.
And the same people you met while you were up, you're going to meet them coming back down again.
Yes, Lord.
Let
Thank
me tell you,
God.
Be careful how you burn uh-huh. your bridges.
Yes.
Look what it
yes.
states here. That they not be conceited,
uh-huh.
nor trust in uncertain
mm-hmm.
riches.
Mm-hmm.
You know how the stock market
yes.
go up and down.
Mm-hmm.
You know how the interest in the bank go up and down. Everything is uncertain.
Yes.
Look at here.
But
he says in uncertain riches, mm-hmm. but in the living God. Put your trust
yes.
in the living God
yes.
who richly
uh-huh.
gives us all things
yes.
to enjoy.
Yes.
Now when God bless you with a spacious home,
mm-hmm.
several vehicles and all, he wants you to enjoy
yes.
but he does not want you to make a God out of it
yes.
and kick him to the
uh-huh.
curb and depend on mm-hmm. your wealth
yes.
to do the work
yes.
for you.
Yes.
Always
you,
keep God
first
uh-huh. and foremost
yes.
in your life.
Hallelujah.
Somebody right now is dealing with a lower disc
yes.
in the lower level.
God
is saying, I'm putting
yes.
it back in alignment right
yes.
now. Somebody
Lord,
said, I almost lost my mind,
my God.
But God
Thank
is restoring
God.
The balance
Hallelujah.
Of your mind
Jesus.
Right
Thank
now.
You, Lord.
He's
Hallelujah.
Renewing your
yes.
mind.
You,
Emptied the garbage
yes.
out and put some fresh
yes.
stuff
some
in there
stuff.
Coming
yes.
from God. Put
Thank
some
you, God.
Fresh manna
yes.
in there that's going to come
God.
From God.
Yes.
Look
Thank
what he states
Lord.
Here. I gave you the blessing
mm-hmm.
for you to enjoy,
uh-huh.
not to fall in love with. God blesses
mm-hmm,
you
mm-hmm.
that you be willing
yes,
to bless his kingdom.
Yes,
and upon you
Lord.
Blessing his kingdom,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
when he knows that you can be trusted,
yes.
he multiplies
yes,
your blessings
yes,
again
yes,
and again
yes,
and again.
Yes, thank you,
God will
yes, yes,
bless you
Hallelujah,
when you
Jesus.
Trust
yes,
in the Lord
you,
with
Lord.
All of your heart.
Yes,
so when you ask God,
mm-hmm.
ask God and believe. Look
yes,
what James 4 and 2 states.
Uh-huh.
He said, ye have not. You ain't got nothing.
Mm-hmm.
I'm putting it in plain English
mm-hmm.
now. You have not
yes.
because you ask
uh-huh.
not.
Uh-huh.
And when you do ask
uh-huh.
me, you don't believe
yes.
that I'm going to
what
do it.
Yes.
So why ask
yes, yes.
for something that you don't believe
uh-huh.
is going to happen?
Yes.
Like my analogy
yes.
was with the children.
Uh-huh.
When they ask, they come with expectation.
Yes.
They know it's not going to be no. They
yes.
know that they're going to be blessed. Am
uh-huh.
I right about
yes,
it? Amen.
Jesus.
So you continue
yes,
to trust
yes.
in the Lord
yes.
with all your heart.
Oh, yes.
And know this last thing.
Uh-huh.
God gives freely. You can't work for it. I heard, child, I'm working
mm-hmm.
this thing out.
Mm-hmm.
God going to do this.
Mm-hmm.
They think their work's going
yes.
to get them what they need
no.
from God. I'm
going
yeah. to visit the sick.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going here to preach.
Yes.
I'm doing this. I'm
uh-huh.
doing that. You're a busybody.
Yes.
Help me, Holy Ghost. You can't
yes.
you can't do that and
uh-huh.
expect God to pay you for
All
it.
Right.
If
yes.
he paid you down here,
uh-huh.
what yes. are you going to receive
yes.
when you get to glory?
Hallelujah, Jesus.
So he stated in Romans 8 and 32, my
mm-hmm.
last verse,
mm-hmm.
he that spared not his own son, talking about God
uh-huh.
now, but delivered him up
mm-hmm.
for us all, how shall he
mm-hmm.
not with him also
mm-hmm.
freely give us all things?
Mm-hmm.
God wants to bless you.
Mm-hmm.
He made it a legal right
mm-hmm.
when he sacrificed, had his son
yes.
sacrificed.
Mm-hmm.
You remember Abram when he was going to sacrifice his son,
mm-hmm.
Isaac. God stopped him because he had his blessing coming up
yes.
on the other side.
Yes,
but God didn't stop himself
mm-hmm.
when he gave
yes.
his only begotten
mm-hmm.
son. And his son kept the mission
yes.
and was brutalized
mm-hmm.
and whipped. And lied upon
yes,
the chest
yes, yes,
and died
yes.
for you
mm-hmm.
and for me.
Yes.
That's what God did.
Yes.
Now, who couldn't love a God
Hallelujah,
who
Jesus.
Allowed his son
yes.
to be crucified, mm. to be able to legally,
yes, yes.
by his word. I want you to get this right here.
Yes.
Now, you have the legal right
mm-hmm.
when you become a joint heir
mm-hmm.
to receive from God
yes.
whatever you are asking him for,
yes.
he can legally
oh, yeah.
give it to
yes.
you.
Yes.
Why?
Hallelujah.
Because you are now
yes.
a part of the covenant
yes.
of the kingdom of God.
Oh, yes.
You have
thank
received
you,
Jesus Christ
uh-huh.
as Lord yes. and Savior
thank
of your life.
Yes.
You have
Lord.
Confessed him
mm-hmm.
and you are believing
yes.
in him. Now you have
yes.
taken the onus
uh-huh.
off of you
yes.
trying to make everything right.
Hallelujah.
And you can go to the
yes.
Father
Hallelujah.
In the name of the
oh,
Son
yes.
and
oh,
you can
Jesus.
Ask God
for
what you need
yes.
and you can expect
yes,
God through
thank
faith.
Yes.
You got to believe
mm-hmm.
that God will.
Yes.
Now, don't ask God for something
mm-hmm.
that's going to be detrimental
that's
to you.
Right.
Don't
that's
ask
right.
God for something that's
yes.
not legal.
Yes.
Ask
thank
God for what is righteous.
Right. Yes.
I guarantee
Hallelujah.
You. How many of you need a miracle?
Yes.
Let God work your miracle.
Yes.
Tell your
yes,
neighbor,
God.
Let God work your miracle. Type
miracle.
It in. Talk to God.
Yes,
a lot
God.
Of us don't ask God
yes.
for what we need,
thank
and
God.
We just assume
yes, yes,
that God knows. God knows.
Oh, yes,
but God say,
yes,
out of your mouth, God. You can speak
yes,
creation.
Yes,
don't
God.
You know that
God.
When you speak
yes,
blessings upon blessings, you
yes.
can even speak curses in
yes.
their formulate
uh-huh,
because
yes.
of the power
God.
That you have
yes.
through
yes.
speaking.
Yes.
God showed you that through speaking,
yes.
he created
yes.
the heavens and the earth.
Yes,
through speaking, you
yes.
can create an atmosphere
yes.
in your life that'll
yes.
be a blessing
yes.
to you.
Hallelujah.
Oh, y'all don't hear
Glory
me here. Through believing in God,
yes.
God and the
yes.
blood that
thank
his son
God.
Jesus shed out on Calvary
uh-huh.
for all our unrighteousness
yes.
and
thank
sin.
Uh-huh.
Amen. It'll take
yes.
away the fatigueness in your life.
Uh-huh.
It'll take away the stress
yes.
when you confess.
Hallelujah.
The depression that's killing a whole
yes.
lot of folk.
God.
The frustration
uh-huh.
and the loneliness
yes.
and the hurt
yes.
and the
yes.
anger.
Thank
These
God.
Are emotional
yes.
problems
you,
that are destroying
yes.
many of
God.
Us today
yes.
because we need the mental help. Y'all
yes.
ain't talking
Hallelujah.
To me. And God can provide.
Oh, yes.
Taste
Lord.
And see
yes.
that the Lord is
on,
good.
God.
The Lord is saying, come
yes.
here.
Yes.
I got something for you.
Yes.
Even
yes.
in your physical part.
Thank
with
you,
that
God.
Cancer, breast
ah,
cancer,
my God.
With bone
yes.
cancer.
Yes.
With oh, y'all don't hear me here.
Hallelujah.
God said, I solved the problem.
Hallelujah.
I don't Calvary.
Yes.
You got to believe and trust
yes.
in me.
Yes.
And I'll show you
yes.
unequivocally that I am Jehovah
yes.
Rapha.
Hallelujah.
I am the healer.
Yes.
I am the deliverer.
Yes.
I am joy
yes.
in the midst of your sorrow.
Lord,
even when you feel like a motherless
yes.
child,
thank
I'm with you
yes.
because I promise
yes.
you.
Yes.
I'm not going to treat you like man.
Yes.
I'll be with you. I
yes.
can recreate our
yes.
entire life for you if you trust
God.
Me.
God.
Taste and see.
Yes.
He said that one with lymphoma cancer.
Yes.
I come tonight.
Right
all your lip nodes
yes.
might
God.
Be swollen, but tonight,
tonight
the blood of
the
Jesus Christ.
Jesus.
I call on Jesus. No, I can't
Lord,
heal you, but I serve a
yes.
God that is able to
yes.
heal.
Yes.
I serve a God
you,
that
God.
Has all power
yes.
in his hand.
Yes.
I serve a
yes.
God,
thank
amen,
God.
That can make him
yes. Lord,
Lord go on the run.
Yes.
I serve a God that
yes.
can take muscular
yes.
aches and
yes.
muscular dystrophy.
Yes.
Yes, I'm speaking
oh,
to you.
Yes,
it's not
thank
too
God.
Hard for God.
Hallelujah.
That stroke that you
yes.
incurred,
thank
tonight
God.
Your blood is going
oh,
to balance
yes,
out.
Thank
the addiction
God.
That you've been
yes,
suffering
God.
From,
thank
tonight, God said, cast
God.
It on me. I did. I canceled
yes.
that demon's
yes.
assignment.
Thank
and
God.
I apply the blood of the crucified
Jesus.
Savior
Hallelujah,
upon
God.
His heart.
Glory.
Help
Hallelujah,
me, Jesus, that spirit of anger. Financial life
yes,
tonight.
God. Thank you, Lord.
We come
yes,
against
God.
You.
Yes.
Sow a seed, my
yes,
brother
God.
And sister.
Thank you, Lord.
Trust
God.
The Lord.
Yes.
I dare you
yes,
to do it. You're
God.
Suffering from emotional
you,
heartache,
yes,
anxiety,
yes,
and
God.
Fear.
Yes.
Tonight is
thank
your
you.
Night.
Yes.
Tonight
God.
Is your
yes.
night.
Thank you, Lord.
I was talking with a young man today,
yes.
and he was telling me about COVID and what
yes.
they went through.
Mm-hmm.
But through COVID,
mm-hmm.
he declared that he was born again.
Hallelujah.
And I can
Jesus.
Tell you one thing. Sometimes God will knock you or allow you to be knocked
yes.
to your knees
oh, yes.
to understand
yes,
that he is God.
Yes, God.
and that he had never lost the case.
Never lost
he had never.
Yes,
taste and see.
Yes,
David said that the Lord is
good.
That the Lord is good. If this message has been a blessing to you, I want you to just give God a great big hand of praise and tell God, thank you. You've been good to me. Amen. And I shall receive my healing tonight. I shall receive my deliverance tonight. I shall receive my emotional healing, my physical healing tonight, my spiritual healing. Come upon me. Fall fresh, Holy Ghost. Fall fresh, Holy Ghost. I've been fooling myself that I was all right. I've been acting like I was all right. But it was fake, God. Make me real again. Make me real again. I want to be whole again. I want to be the blood bought and the redeemed. If this message, these words of exhortation have been a blessing to you, we want you to look on our platform there. There's a place of giving, and you can sow tonight. If you're not a member of a church, you can also render your tithe there. I ask that you give a truthful love offering tonight to the Elm Grove Baptist Church. If need be, and you want to bless the pastor and the first lady, you can look at our Cash App. There's $ Reverend and Sister Thomas. We ask that you be reminded that God is yet on the throne, and whatever you sow into God, look at as a farmer. When you sow, you're going to get at least 10 times more than what you sowed in the seed. God promises to multiply. In this season and in this time, God is a great giver. And all he wants you to do is give yourself to him. Give yourself away and watch God work it out. Now, if you're out of the ark of safety and you need a savior tonight, right where you're at, I would like for you to verbally or within yourself just confess Jesus as Lord and Savior. Lord Jesus, tonight I come to you just as I am. I have sinned and I repent. And I believe that Jesus died on Calvary's cross and that he rose from the dead on the third day and is seated at the right hand of God, our Father, in heaven right now. Therefore, I'm saved, I'm saved, I'm saved. Come on and give the Lord a hand of praise, my brothers and sisters. Amen. I just want to thank God for you and your presence, and I pray that God has blessed you with something from this word, that you have gleaned something from this word that would entitle you to know that being a blood-bought, redeemed child of God, you are privileged, my brother and my sister. Use what you got and let God bless you. Now, tomorrow, on Thursday evening, that is tomorrow evening at 7 p.m., the Elm Grove Baptist Church will be on program at the Prospect Baptist where we are celebrating with them their church's anniversary. Also, on Saturday from 11 a.m. to 4 p.m., the Elm Grove Baptist Church will be having a barbecue picnic for the church family and any visitors that would like to come. Bring a visitor, bring a family member, bring a friend. But we have a great menu set up for you, and we pray that you will enjoy this time. It's a time of food, fun, games, and fellowship. We're going to relax, amen, and just have a great time. And Lord, great food is being prepared for you, and we just pray that you will enjoy to the utmost. And Sunday morning, amen, will be Holy Communion morning. Amen. Come if you're going to be looking at us via live stream. Have your juice and your wafer prepared as we prepare to present the Lord's Supper. And that evening at 3 p.m., First Lady and I will be the guest preachers at Greater Morris Chapel Missionary Baptist Church in Jessup, Georgia, where the pastor is Dr. Darren Moore. We ask that if you can, come and share with us. We would love to see you, especially in the Jessup area. Amen. Anywhere you're at, Folkestone, wherever you're at, come on down. Let's have a good time in the Lord. So, brothers and sisters, we thank God for you, and we look forward to seeing you very soon. Amen. So, in our conclusion, let us pray. Abba, Father God, we thank you for all things. I thank you, Father, for giving us a word that perhaps was a blessing to your people tonight. Allow the words of my mouth and the meditations of mine heart to be acceptable in thine sight. If there's anyone that needs anything from you, let them be reassured that you are a liberal giver and you want to bless beyond our greatest expectation. No, you're not angry with us. You're just waiting on us. Bless now, Lord. Cover all through the airwaves. Homes, Father, might be in distraught. People might be distressed. Bring a calmness back to them, O Lord, and let them see the wonder-working power that you and you alone possess. So we thank you in advance, and we bless you, Father, in the matchless name of Jesus the Christ. And everybody said amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And amen. So if you go with God, God will go with you. If you stay with God, I guarantee you, God will stay with you. God bless you, and we look forward to seeing you tomorrow night, or Saturday or Sunday. One of those times. Come on down. Let's have a good time in the Lord. God bless you, and stay at peace.